circles and angles.
Hello. Today we're demonstrating an NVE AAT-003 non-contact angle sensor in a stepper motor servo system. The demonstration shows the unique capabilities of the AAT-003 tunneling magnetoresistance sensor and how easy it is to interface these sensors to microcontrollers. The demonstration will also show a simple magnetic proximity sensor. Here's the demo. We have an AAT angle sensor mounted on this board and a split pole magnet. You can buy these kits on our website. We've modified this clock to serve as a position indicator. We replaced the clock motor with a stepper motor so we can turn the hand either direction. There's a disc magnet on the hand and an AD004 proximity sensor behind the clock face to orient the clock hand. The AD004 proximity sensor is quite sensitive to allow a wide air gap, and it's very repeatable for accurate positioning. I suppose we'll have to put the clock back together when we're done. We have an Arduino board to read the sensors, and we have a stepper motor driver. The proximity sensor is digital, and the angle sensor has large output signals, so we have no amplification for this demo. And just the 10-bit A to D built into an inexpensive microcontroller. When we start up, the controller aligns the clock hand with the proximity sensor, then moves it to the angle sensor position. When we turn the magnet, the clock hand tracks the magnet position, and it's quite accurate. Here's how the angle sensor works. The split pole magnet provides a saturating magnetic field in the plane of the sensor. As the applied field rotates, the resistance of the tunneling magnetoresistance elements change, which varies the output voltages. Here's the program. There's not much to it, but you can email us at sensor-apps@nve.com if you'd like the code. We read the two angle sensor outputs here. The sensor is running on a single supply, so we subtract the offset V0, typically half the supply. The simplest way to get the indicated angle is the inverse tangent of the ratio of the cosine and sine outputs. We could take the inverse sine and cosine of each output, but we'd have to scale the outputs and figure out the quadrature. But because the arctangent calculation is a ratio, it doesn't need scaling and cancels power supply variations. The two-variable arctan calculation provides a full 360-degree range. The rest of the program steps the motor either direction to track the sensor output. And finally, this section initiates the clock hand. So to sum up, we've demonstrated that AAT sensors are ideal for closed-loop control. These sensors have large output signals. Sine and cosine outputs provide quadrature. They're precise, and they come in an ultra-miniature package. Call, click, or email for more information, or to buy sensors or evaluation kits.